One of the top priorities of our world is decoupling economic growth from resource use. This means that a rise in our living standards should not increase our use of natural resources. SDG 12, Responsible Consumption and Production, aims to find new solutions and ways that enable sustainable consumption and production patterns. My name is Karthik Krishnamurthy, an MBA graduate here at the Rotterdam School of Management, and I am the proud ambassador for SDG 12. Product manufacturers have a great responsibility to contribute to this goal, as they have a direct impact through the products they sell and design. Yet we, their customers, are just as critical because of the choices we make every day to buy one product over another. One of the targets of SDG 12 is to halve the global food waste by 2030, both at the retail and consumer level and during the production and supply chain process. Firstly, sustainable consumption is the idea that while responding to your basic needs, it is still possible to go for options with minimal impact on the global environment and on the situation of future generations. For instance, when buying something, one can follow the 5 R's. 1. Refuse. Do I really need this? 2. Reduce. Do I need this much? 3. Reuse. Do I have to throw it away now? 4. Repurpose. Can I use this for another purpose? And 5. Recycle. Can the materials be used for something else? Yet, the vast majority of us do not favor the most sustainable option when purchasing goods or services. The value action gap is the discrepancy between one's willingness to act in favor of the environment and the actual action taken by that person. In the coming videos, you will learn more about sustainable consumption. First, Anne-Catherine Klesse, Assistant Professor at the Department of Marketing Management of RSM, will explain her current research on the potential of language to encourage sustainable consumption choices. Then, Michael Wilde, Sustainability and Communications Manager at EOSTA, an international distributor of fresh organic fruits and vegetables, will introduce us to the challenge of consumer communication. Second, sustainable production refers to the producer's responsibility not to exhaust natural resources and ecosystems through their operations. Because the global population is still growing and developing, our need for goods, even the most basic ones, is expected to grow while our natural resources capacity remains limited and constantly decreases. Alarmingly, we are producing ever more waste, especially in large cities. This is because our economy still relies on linear production patterns. The life cycle of a product starts with the extraction of resources, which are then transformed, sold, used, and finally end up as waste. But as the founder of Goldfinger Factory, Oliver Waddington Ball, puts it, waste is just another resource in the wrong hands. By closing the loop between the input and the output, and between the resource and the waste, our economy can be one step closer to resemble a real ecosystem. And businesses can profit from that by adapting their procurement processes and the resource efficiency of their products. In the coming video, Ferdinand Jaspers, Adjunct Professor of Entrepreneurship at RSM and Program Director at Erasmus Center for Entrepreneurship, will tell you more about the role of entrepreneurship in bringing about innovations within larger companies to stir them to fulfill SDG 12. Harold Trepper, Program Lead, Circular Economy and MT member of the Group Sustainability at Philips, will explain how his company is implementing a full circular economy strategy. He will also tell about the organizational challenges that such a shift implies in a large multinational firm.